Hello and welcome to our new series to help you prepare, upgrade, and manage Office in your organization. Now, this series primarily focuses on helping you move from an older version of Office to a current release and what you need to do to stay up to date. Now, if you've been using a Professional Plus or standard version of Office 2010 or newer in your organization, or are in the process of adopting Office 365, we're going to walk you through the detailed steps of what you need to know. Oh, and if you're following our desktop deployment wheel, this relates primarily to steps 1 for device and app readiness, and 3 for Office delivery. Now, first, let me address a few questions that might be on your mind. The first question that most people have is, will your customizations, including Office add-ins and macros, continue to work? Now, the good news here is that minimal changes have been made regarding extensibility for COM add-ins so that up to 99% or more of what you have will still work, and we'll show you the tools to assess your readiness and additional resources available to you if you need help with fixes. Next, you might be wondering if your activation will continue to work as is. Now, if you're using volume activation like KMS or Mac, that will only work for Office 2019 volume licensing and won't work for Office 365. Now, that's because Office 365, in that case, the user is at the center and the activations are predicated on their sign-in, which also unlocks major value of the cloud with the ability to work across devices, have content centrally stored, easily accessible, and collaboration capabilities such as co-authoring and sharing. And if you didn't know, you actually get 5 activations per user for PCs and Macs, and 5 more for mobile devices. And last, we're often asked if you still have control over how Office is installed, configured, and updated if you're moving to Office 365. Now, the answer here is that in some respects, you actually have more control. Now, first, it's still a local install of Office that works with or without the internet. And you don't need to be a local admin on your PC to run it. In fact, there are more controls than you had before over how updates are applied. Now, you can either select whether to receive updates monthly or semi-annually through the channels, or you can decide to make updates fully manual for complete control over when you receive them. Now, beyond that, you can use new tools to reduce network bandwidth, such as Pure Cache with System Center Configuration Manager and Delivery Optimization in Windows 10. Now, that said, you'll need to update some of your existing processes because Microsoft Office is no longer using the MSI-based packaging and tools that you may have been using since Office 2007. Now, most of what I'm going to show you in this series still applies to Office 2019 deployment, which also uses Click to Run. Now, we'll also show you how you can take advantage of monthly feature updates for your most common general purpose devices and optionally take a more manual approach for updates to highly customized business essential devices. Now, with that said, let's break this down for you. We're going to help you prepare for your Office upgrade, including prerequisites, readiness tools, and policy options, perform your upgrade, including install configuration, package creation, and deployment targeting. Then we're going to wrap up by showing you how you can continue to manage Office in your environment, from update management options, adding apps, languages, or configurations to existing installs, and finally, troubleshooting and managing issues. And we'll highlight key things that get better as you adopt new approaches, from the flexibility offered by leveraging the cloud for things like policy enforcement with the new Office Cloud Policy Service for any internet-connected Office 365 attached PC, and streamlining the delivery of Office where you can use the internet and peer-to-peer caching to augment software distribution. Let's get started.